Let's take a moment to meditate on the fact that this code, like many class patterns in JavaScript, has two distinct and very different sections. This will be true of every pseudo-classical, prototypal, and functional shared class that you write. In one section, you will find that you're specifying how all the instances of a class should be similar. In the case of the pseudo-classical pattern, these similarities are generally stored as properties of the prototype object. In the other section, you'll be writing code that specifies how each instance should be different from all the other instances. As with most programming languages, this will take place inside the body of the constructor function, and it'll allow us to specify how one instance of a class will be different from another instance of a class. All of the work that gets done to specify that Amy and Ben have unique locations is done inside that constructor function. For now, this is just an interesting observation about classes, but knowing that these two categories of code exist for every class will become very important later when we start to discuss subclassing. Looking back at the functional version of this class for a moment, it's also interesting to notice that functional classes without shared methods make no such distinction. In this style, all the code for both categories appears in one place. The similarities and the differences across instances appear here indented two spaces inside the car function. Depending on your perspective, you could call this an asset or a failing of the functional pattern.